darling.
Yeah, so he told me. It was naughty of him, wasn't it?
Indeed it was. And not congratulating me is naughty, too.
Oh, I'm sorry. What were you on?
I know it must seem to you that I'm on a marital merry-go-round trying for all the brass rings, but this time it's different.
You can say that again.
Oh, I realize that his background is impossible, but please don't judge him from that point of view.
Well, what point of view do you suggest, Mother?
A woman's.
Well, I find that highly impractical.
You could understand if you tried. You won't miss the wedding.
Mother, have I ever missed one of your weddings?
Yes, the first one.
Bye.
Bye, darling. Oh, Agnes, tonight you are Queen of Romania.
Chanting.
Oh, golly.
Oh, Ryan, hang those fizz on the gooch. Hurry.
Auntie Mame, this is Gloria. Gloria Upson. This is my Auntie Mame. This is Burnside.
I can't tell you how pleased I am to make your acquaintance.
Yes. Come in, children. Do please. There are some friends of mine here I'd like you to meet.
And you mean you promised?
Oh, this is my secretary, Miss Gooch, my good right hand, my Boswell, as it were. This is Miss Upson and my nephew, Patrick, and this is, what is your boyfriend's name again, dear? Oh, Banyan.
We're going to put her in her place right off.
Welcome home, Mrs. Ray.
Thank you, Mabel.
Welcome home.
Oh, Paige, thank you. What a pleasure it is to see you. Emmeline, you look so pretty. Wiley, I look forward to getting to know my new family now.
Shall we call you Ma or Mrs.?
Wouldn't Ellen be easier?
Where, may I ask, is our father?
Oh, he wanted to take a drive around the properties before coming home. You all remember Parrish? Your father thought it would be nice if Parrish moved in with us for the first month, at least, so that we could all get to know each other. I guess I'll freshen up a bit before Judd gets here.
Oh, please let me show you your room.
You.
Well, how do you like the new me?
Molto bella.
I know. I heard.
The doctor says Charles will be all right after a little rest. He's been sleeping.
When he wakes up, let me know.
I'm quite awake, Hamish.
the sheriff and his hounds onto that Rao-Roo of yours. I want to see the look on your face when they bring him in.
They'll never bring him in. But take a good look at my face, anyhow. Stand over there, man.
No, don't.
Stand over there.
You're a fool, Amos. I could outshoot you on
that.
At Lindbergh's story. After making final inspection of his plane, the Spirit of St. Louis, Lindy returned to his hotel room early this evening, telling reporters he had nothing to say. The airmail pilot went directly to his room on the second floor where he went to bed.
Goodness sake, Papa. They aren't children any longer.
So I've noticed. It's not Paul I worry about. Just Dirk. Don't let her run your life, boy.
She's not happy unless she's pulling the strings.
And from whom do you suppose I inherited that little trait?
Oh, that. Richard Hollis's whole architectural department is merely a matter of accommodation for the construction end of the business. That's where the important money is, Dirk. Contracting, selling.